morning, back at Thorpe Park today to check out Oktoberfest and hopefully do my top 10 rides. Seems like a relatively quiet day, so we should be able to ride some, and I'm going to do my 10, counting down from 10 to 1 throughout the day. So let's go. So, starting with number 10, let's go. So there's number 10, the rapids, or bumper rapids today because of Oktoberfest. But the reason that's in there as a number 10 is it's an iconic classic ride for me. It's one of the first rides I ever remember coming on when I came to Thorpe Park 30 years ago maybe. And it's just always stayed the same, and they've changed the name a few times, but it's just a classic ride for me, and it had to be in the top 10. So yeah, let's go on to number 9. So the Walking Dead at number 9, I've got quite an opinion on that because I know it's probably a lot higher on other people's, but I just feel they could made that ride a lot better. I think the ride itself isn't great, and the only reason it's actually made the top 10 is down to the theming and everything else that's come with it. So I think they could do better, and I think they should have actors in it all the time, at least one, just to make it scary on the entrance or the exit. But yeah, that's why it's in the top 10, sorry. So yeah, let's go. One good thing about doing it in this order is that obviously everyone rushes to the big rides at the start of the day, whereas I've just walked on those two without even queuing, so it's just made it a lot better. And then obviously later in the day, hopefully it gets quieter and I haven't got a queue, so this might work out quite well. So let's go and check out number 8. So number 8, Samurai. Although, I know they closed it for quite a while recently, and it's so different now. It's much longer, it's slower. I think in all honesty, if that ride there I prefer to the old one, I would probably put it slightly higher up the list. Just because some of the other stuff we've got coming up, I think that is better than now with the new format. So I don't know if anyone else has noticed a difference, but it's definitely different. So yeah, that's number 8. Take my breath away a little bit there, because it just goes on for ages. It's like literally feels like about 3-4 minutes. It's just, yeah, it's crazy. So yeah, let's go. So I'm getting a bit hungry now, but I think I'm going to squeeze in number 7 before lunch. So let's see what number 7 is. Thank you. So number seven is Rush. And adding to what I said about Samurai, I think that would definitely, Samurai would now replace that, because that's the opposite. That feels like that doesn't go on long enough now. It gets to the top and then it stops, and it's like you need a couple of goes when it gets to the highest point, I think. And I'm sure it used to go on longer than that. So yeah, so that's number seven, but controversially. So I think I'm going to go and get something to eat now, try Oktoberfest, maybe get some bratwurst and a beer potentially, and yeah, see what that's offering. Had the bratwurst, it was really nice, and didn't have a beer because they weren't open, so don't know if that's just because of it being Sunday or beginning, I don't know. So I didn't get to have one of those, but maybe later if it opens up and we'll try one. But yeah, I'm gonna break my own rule now and go on a ride straight after food. Normally I go on something a bit more gentle, but as I've used most of those in the first sort of four rides, so we're gonna go and check out number six now. Let's go. Controversial one, I know, in terms of, I know it's not up there on most people's list, but for me it's one of those rides that every time I usually come to Fort Park, it's usually the first one I do, so it's the thing that gets me most excited about Fort Park, because when I'm thinking about coming here, that's what I get excited for. So yeah, that's number six, which means we're now into the top five, so I can now start riding some of the bigger rides. So it's getting exciting now. Queues are relatively short, so let's go to number five. Number five, Colossus. It would have been higher up, in all honesty, if I wasn't accounting for more factors. If it was just purely for the ride, and for me, it would have been quite high up there in terms of 9-10, just because it's so uncomfortable now. But that's me, I'm tall, and it really applies a lot of pressure on my shoulders, on my head, and I just don't really enjoy it. But that being said, it's iconic. It was groundbreaking when it was first made. It still holds numerous records and things like that, but I now think it's getting left behind a bit, and there are better rides. Not just in Fort Park, but around the world there's better rides. So I think it's been iconic, it's been good, but I've hit my limits with it now, and I went on it for the video, but I rarely go on it any other time. So that's number five, so that leaves us with number four. Let's go. 4 was Nemesis. Nemesis is it's a great ride. I don't dislike it. I think it easily slots into 4 because there are 3 better rides than that. So this is where it gets a bit serious now. So we're now into the top 3. So let's go to number 3. Number 3 was Stealth. I love it. I do really love that ride. And I think if you're at the front, which I was lucky enough to be at, it is just one of the best. But I think if you're not, it's not as good, but still up there. So yeah, number 3, which leads us on to the top 2, which is difficult. There are 2 standout rides for me at this place. So let's go to number 2. So before doing the top 2, it's just started to rain. So I was walking past the sign for the Black Mirror Labyrinth and there was availability. So I booked a slot for that. I'm gonna go and check that out because I haven't done that yet, so we're gonna see what that's like. It's not in my top 10 because I haven't done it, but I'm gonna go and check it out anyway while there's availability. So just popped into Black Mirror Labyrinth. It was quite good actually. I'm not sure how sort of re-rideable, redoable it is, because it's, I think once you've done it once, that's kind of the aspect of it is. But it was good, I enjoyed it, and it's sort of almost like a taste of Horror Nights. Get me ready for when I do come back next week to give that a go. So yeah, I enjoyed that, but it's not in the top 10, so let's go to number 2. So at number 2 is Saw. Riding that just reminds me how close those top 3 are. They are all great rides, fantastic rides. So let's recap on the top 10. So that brings us to number 1, which I think you guys already guessed it, is obviously the Flying Fish. I'm only joking. It's of course the Swarm. Let's go. There it is, number 1, Swarm. I don't think that was much of a secret. Every time I come here, I love this ride. I go on it as much as I can. Even so, I'm actually going to go back on it because it's 5-minute wait time. So I'm going to go back on it again before heading out of the park. But yeah, like I said, there's your top 10. That's based on the rides I go on the most, the ones I have sort of emotional attachment to, and just the ones I think are the better ones, with the theme in and everything else taken into account. So thank you very much for watching. And I will see you again soon. I'm back here for Fright Nights in about 6 days. So I'll see you again then. Thank you very much. Take care now. Bye bye.